Hi there and welcome to this video about finding volumes. And in this particular video, we're going to explore several different solids that can be generated from one region. You can see the region right here. And we will find the volume of each one of these solids using an appropriate method. So we're going to look at three different methods. And this region is formed by the lines y equals 2, the curve y equals square root of x, and the y-axis. And I've already shaded the region that we're looking at. So let's go ahead and look at our first solid. The first solid we are going to define by taking cross sections perpendicular to the y-axis and making them squares. So we're going to use this region. The first thing to do when you're doing these volume problems is to interpret what's going on, and usually I like to draw a picture of what's going on there. So if we're looking at cross sections or slices, think of these as slices, and we want these cross sections to be perpendicular to the y-axis. So we're going to slice in this direction. And each one of these cross sections is actually going to be a square. So if we were to draw kind of a three-dimensional picture of what's happening here, these cross sections would pop off of the page here, and we have a bunch of squares. Kind of like slices of bread, but the slices are smaller and smaller and smaller as you're approaching this point here, which is 0, 0. And then they get larger and larger and larger as we approach this boundary here, which is set by the points 0, 2 and 4, 2. Okay, so basically what we want to do is we want to stack up all of these squares so that we get a solid formed by these regions. So in order to do that, the first thing we want to do is figure out what the area of each square is. Now we know the area formula for a square is s squared, where the s is the side length. So what we need to do is figure out what each of these side lengths is. So I'm going to draw these squares over here, just do a little sketch. And this is my side length, so I'm going to call this S. And it's S is defined by the length between these two curves, where this is the curve y equals the square root of x, and this is the curve, this vertical line here, is the curve x equals 0, because it chops the x-axis at 0. Now, if you look at these slices of bread, or these squares that we're stacking up, we're stacking them in the y direction. So if you look at how we're stacking these, all these slices are getting stacked in this direction. So this problem is a dy problem. So that's the next thing we're going to determine. We're going to have to add all these up to add things, to add an infinite number of slices. We're going to use an integral. We're going to go in the dy direction. And what we need to do is we need to add up all of these areas, which are squares. So we're going to sum the areas. Since we're going in the dy direction, all of these areas need to be in terms of y. And we need to start at the lowest y value here, which is y equals 0. And we need to stop at this y value, which is y equals 2. So our limits of integration are going to go from 0 to 2. Okay, so we've determined how we're going to find our volume. This is going to equal our volume. And next thing we need to do is figure out the expression for the area that we want to integrate. Now, since everything needs to be in terms of y, that means we need to take these guys and put them into x equals form. So an equivalent form of this would be x equals y squared. And we've already determined that over here, this curve here is this x equals 0. So we're using these two guys, but this one we're putting into x equals y squared. Okay, so if we look at the length of the side of the square, that's going to be the right hand minus the left hand, or the larger curve minus the smaller curve, and that will give us the length between those two curves. Since we're using not the y equals form, but the x equals form, the length is going to be the right hand curve, which is y squared, minus the left hand curve, which is 0. And the area of a square, the area equals s squared. And in our case, we're going to take our s, which is y squared minus 0, or just y squared, and we're going to square it, which is y to the fourth. This is what goes in here for the area. That's what we're going to integrate, the area of these squares over the interval from 0 to 2 to get a volume of a solid. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. If we do that, our volume is going to equal the integral from 0 to 2 of y to the fourth dy, which is equal to y to the fifth over 5, evaluated from 0 to 2. If we plug in 2, we get 32 over 5. If we plug in 0, we get 0 over 5. So the volume of our solid is 32 fifths. Let's go ahead and look at the next example I've given you with the same region. Okay, with the second solid, what we're going to do is we're going to find the volume formed when the given region is revolved about the y-axis. So we're going to take this region and we're going to swing it around so it rotates in that direction. So we're going to have some symmetry here. When this swoops around, swings around and around and around, we're going to get something that looks very symmetrical on the other side. So we're going to get this kind of cone-shaped thing, inverted cone, but it's not a cone because these are curved. All right, so this is what we're going to look at. First thing you always do is draw. Now, if you look at what we've drawn, these slices or these cross sections are circles. So each one of these areas that we're going to be trying to figure out is a circle. So remember, when we want to find the volume of the solid formed, we need to figure out what the area of the slice is. A slice is a circle. And we know the area of a circle is pi r squared. So we need to figure out what the radius is. We need to decide if we're stacking things in the y direction or in the x direction. Now if you see here, when I'm finding my radii, I'm stacking them in the y direction, right? So I'm going to have all kinds of circles stacked in the y direction. So let's go ahead and do that first. We're going to write our integral. So our integral is going to start at 0. I'm going to stack all of these circles. They're getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger as we end at 2. So we're going from 0 to 2, and we're going in the dy direction. And we want to add up all of these areas, and the areas we have decided are circles. And they all need to be in terms of y because we're stacking things in the dy direction. All right, so our next task is to figure out what this area is in terms of y. And the area is pi r squared. So we need to figure out what this radius is from here to here. Now, since everything is working in the dy direction, again, we need to go ahead and make sure everything is in x equals form. We're going to write this as x equals y squared. And then the two curves that we're looking at, again, this is the line x equals 0. And this curve, we're going to call it x equals y squared. And the distance between these two curves, or our radius, is going to equal this right curve minus the left-hand curve, or y squared minus 0. So when I find the area, I can go ahead and substitute that in. My area is going to equal pi times my radius, which is y squared, and I'm going to square that, so my area is going to be pi y to the fourth. If I add up or stack up an infinite number of areas over my region, I'm going to have the result that's my volume. So that's why the volume is this result. I'm stacking up an infinite number of these areas, these disks, circular disks from 0 to 2. So my volume is going to be the integral from 0 to 2 of pi y squared dy. Now you can factor the pi out, remember, and you can rewrite this as pi times, oh, did you catch my mistake? This should be y to the fourth. Let's fix that right now. This should be y to the fourth. There we go. Pretend it never happened. Y to the fourth, much better. So this is going to be y to the fifth over 5, and we're going to integrate from 0 to 2. Now, if you relate this back to the last example, the only difference is this pi, because now we're doing pi r squared gives us circles. We didn't have the pi before, we just had the r squared or the s squared. So when we do this, we're going to have pi times 32 fifths minus pi times 0 fifths, which results in 32 pi over 5, which is our volume. All right, let's look at the next example using the same region.